Hello everyone. So today we are going to see a program to perform array implementation of a stack. In this we are going to perform three operations, that is push, pop and display. So first we will start with our header file, that is hash include stdio.h, which is used for standard input output. It includes scanf and printf, which we use in the program. And then hash include conio.h. conio.h is used for clear screen function and getch function. Now I've written this code to be demonstrated on DOSBox. If you are using Linux, so don't use conio.h because it doesn't support it. So now I am performing this on DOSBox, so keep this in mind. Now hash defined n10. I have given n the value 10 so that I will not use that value 10 everywhere. Wherever I want to use, I will write n, not 10. So I have then defined the structure and gave it a name stack. It is user derived data type. Structure is a user derived data type. So struct stack, and in it I have globally declared variable int a of n array of size n and int top, and close that bracket, and I have declared s. So whenever I have to access top or array, I will use s to access them. Now I will first write the function push. As I am writing function push, I will not use parameters because at the end I will write main function, so no need to use parameters. Now void push function. Void push, we are accepting a value from a user and it will be stored in x. So void push int x. Now whenever we are pushing, we will first see whether the stack is full or not. So to check that situation, we will use if s.top is equal to n minus 1. N is the size, n is the n is the total size of the array, but as array starts from 0, the size will be n minus 1. So n minus 1 will be the topmost position, after which no elements can be inserted. So if top is at n minus 1, so insertion cannot be possible. So we will say stack overflow. But what is that s.top? s.top is we are accessing top by using s.top, pointer to top, s.top. So s.top is equal to n minus 1. If our top is at n minus 1 position, means full, the stack is full and there is no space for insertion, so we will print a statement stack overflow. Else if stack is not full, if there is space remaining in it, so we will increment the top position. s.top is equal to s.top plus 1, and whatever the value given by the user, we will push that value into the top position of the stack in this way, s.a of s.top. s.a of s.a, we are accessing the stack, s.a, in that stack the topmost position, so s.a in bracket s.top. In this way the element will be inserted on the topmost position of the stack. Now the push function is over. Now the pop function. Now we are popping the element, so no need to accept anything from the user. We will declare a variable x. Now we will check whether the stack is empty or not. To check whether the stack is empty, we will write a condition s.top is equal to minus 1. If s.top is equal to minus 1, we will print f that stack is underflow. We use stack underflow in pop and stack overflow in push. Now if this condition is true, stack overflow will be printed. Else if there are elements in the stack and the stack is not empty, then whatever is in the top position of the stack, we will insert that into X. So the top position, whatever will be the top position of the stack, will be empty, and so the top will get decremented. So we will access top by using S. So S dot top is equal to S dot top minus 1. So top will come down by 1, and then the top will be decremented. So now we will print whatever element has been deleted. So X, whatever is the top element, we have removed that element from the top and have collected it in X. So now X has that deleted element. So if the user wants to see what element he has deleted, so he can print that element by using printf statement in this way. So the deleted element will be printed. Now the void display function. Now we have to display what elements are remaining in the stack. So we will declare a variable I and use for loop to display the elements in the stack. So for loop I is equal to s dot top. We will start from topmost element because stack is a LIFO structure. Last in, first out. So whatever is in the top element will be displayed first. So as the top, so top element will be displayed first, and then it will go up to 0th element of the stack, and we are decrementing it as it is shown. So it is initialization, condition, and updation or decrementation. We are decrementing here. So now whatever condition we have given in for loop, we are printing that by using backslash t that tab the three spaces. It will leave three spaces in between the elements, and s dot top will come. So first while the first loop is performed, in place of I there will be s of top. So s dot a of s of top. So whatever element will be on the top portion will be displayed here, and then when it will come out of the loop and then again it will execute, then s dot top minus one element will come here, and then that element will be displayed here. So by keeping three spaces in between two elements, here first element, here second element, here third element, here fourth element will be displayed. In this way display operation will perform, and at the end we will perform the main function. Now to perform main function, we have to assume that the stack is empty. So s dot top is equal to minus 1. So we have not performed any insertion operation before. So the top is at minus 1. Now we will declare c and x, integer variable c and x. Now we will use do while loop. So in do loop we will printf the menu. What we have to do, first we have to push, pop, display, and then enter the choice, exit and enter the choice, scanf. Now percentage comma and c. Now we will use switch case statement. So we have to scan what numbers we want. So we have printed this. Now we are asking him to enter his choice. So whatever choice he will enter, if he enters 2, it will here it will scan 2. If he scans 2, the switch in switch c will be 2. Okay, now all the case we have given below. So let's see the first case. First case is if he chooses push operation. If he enters 1, the execution will start from here, case 1. It will ask him to enter a number to be inserted. Then whatever number he enters, the scanf will scan the number and then push x. Then push, if he enters 5, then push 5. Then this push 5 will go to push function. Here, it will come here, and then int x will be 5. X will be 5. Then 5 will be inserted and it will be inserted in s of a of s dot top position. It is over, then it will come here and break, then it will stop. Now I will explain you everything. If he enters case 2, then the element will be popped. If he enters display, then it will be displayed. If he enters 4 if he wants to exit, then bye will be printed and the execution will be over. And the default statement, if he enters a different choice other than 1 2 3 4, then it will show invalid choice. Now we have shown here that do while loop, if c not equal to 4, that is 4 not equal to 4, it is a wrong statement, so it will be terminated and get ch will be executed. So this is the end of the program. Hope you like the video. Do hit like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you.